guys, this is me Avi Dwivedi and you are listening on Extended DRT Developers of India community. Today we have a very magnificent entrepreneur with us from Bangalore Startup Culture, and she is the founder of Avidia Lab. So without any further delay, let's welcome her on podcast. Hi Vidya, how are you?
Hi Avi, I'm good. How about you?
I'm good. Everything is fine. Sorry for delay in the podcast, but yeah, we are good to go. So let's first start with your introduction. How did you founded this company and what your company does?
So yeah, I'm dropout from IIT Bangalore as a research scholar, and I have completed my M.Tech in electrical engineering, specialized in neural networks, and I have done my B.Tech in electronics and communication. Also GATE qualified in the year 2018 and completed my executive entrepreneur education from IIM Ahmedabad. And prior to founding this company, I was actively working as a consultant with Self-Care LLC, taking guest lectures in Ambia Engineering College and taking lectures as assistant professor in Vyas Institute of Technology College as a full-time. And I'm having my expertise in neural networks, machine learning, augmented reality and virtual reality. So
amazing.
As a CEO of Avidia Labs, yeah, I'm handling multiple roles like project management, sales, marketing, strong business development, etc., etc.
Amazing. So you started your journey in this highly technical field, which is basically managing all these technologies, whether it's neural networks, whether it's virtual reality. So how are you handling that? And when you actually decided that you have to choose this path?
Okay, so actually as a DNA of engineering, I'm always fascinated about the technologies like augmented virtual reality, artificial intelligence, name a few more. So what happened to me in this era, everyone is talking about the digital education nowadays.
Absolutely.
But, it's very difficult for parents to understand all these things. All had their education by the traditional ways of chalk and dusters and from hard-binded books. They are hearing about the industrial revolution. Artificial intelligence is now including class first from CBSE, a very big term for them to understand all these things.
Absolutely.
So their worry is very genuine, and definitely yes. And that was the reason I decided to move one step ahead and take my way to make such a learning environment where they can see the blending of offline and online learning. And from last more than 2 years, I have been working on this idea and fully dedicated to make this dream big. That's how Avidia Labs came into existence, and our mission is to provide a world-class learning environment, digital immersive experience, and engaging young minds while training them for future skills.
Amazing.
So we overcome the boundaries of traditional ways of learning and training.
Yeah. It's a very ambitious goal, and we are really wishing you best of luck for this. Also, let's talk about Avidia Lab some more. So when this company was founded and what this company is all about?
So we founded this company in year 2018 with the mission to make learning more immersive, interacting, engaging, impactful. So we founded in April 2018, we started this company. And the idea behind, we started a year back in 2017. On working on the prototypes of the products.
Amazing. So when we are talking about the prototype, so it's a whole journey creating a prototype. It's a 5 to 7 day process, but creating a product takes life. So how did you travel this journey and what was the experience in between?
So we started this thing in 2018 with the idea that to provide a O2A learning platform to the parents, to the teachers, to the students, where we are making a medium, filling the gap between online and offline education. And we are creating a digital kind of products where any physical thing, or when we can superimpose with the digital application, you can see the augmented reality stuff on that, and children can interact with that content, and students can learn more into deeper and deeper knowledge. So we have a dozens of topics, and we started with the STEM kind of thing because we chose first because science is the most difficult subject.
Absolutely.
I was in childhood, it's very difficult to understand the complex body parts. We don't know that how the that molecules works in micrometer, in nanometer, how the reactions is going to take place. And in laboratory also, we are not allowed to touch any acids or any bases. We don't know what the reaction will be. And so that's why it's very important to make interactive science curriculum in virtual and augmented reality. So we chosen science subject at first, and step by step we will take more mathematics also and language learning also in augmented and virtual reality, more
Okay.
physical stuff and digital applications.
Amazing. So you mentioned you are using augmented reality and merging it with the learning so that student could understand science better. So now my question is, can you describe augmented reality in your words that what to the people who don't know about it, what is actually augmented reality and how it's actually helping the science students?
I will in simple words, augmented reality is simply projecting digital data in 3D form on real world. So you are converting your room into various 3D kind of stuff on your table. You can see, you can interact while having all the things in the real world. So it's a technology that extends the user views of the real world with digital virtual content. So people often confuse with the words that what is VR and what is AR. They found that both are similar, but not. VR is a technology that places the viewer, that teleport the viewer into a digital surroundings and into a computer generated model, while AR places digital objects around the viewer.
Amazing. So means AR is trying to bring out what is not possible in the real world and bring out this virtual elements into the real world, augmenting this our surroundings, right? So I'm side by side, I'm side by side playing one of your videos in which we can see the color book is being augmented, and whatever the student has colored in the book, what is this called, AR? So the color book.
We call that book is color. So we provide dozens of topics of STEM in a gamified manner, and we have launched our VR AR innovative physical things. We call this a phygital, it's the amalgamation of physical and digital things, and that provides one-stop predictive learning solution to students, and with a grade-wise, board-wise, and multiple language support. It's supporting multiple language in the application part. So like that, we launched four applications like that. One is Avidia AR Magic Media. Second is Color, what we have mentioned, that is a coloring book for kids. And third is Avidia AVR Magic Media and Rattus AR. So child can understand more complex topics of science in a better and simpler way, and the student can interact with the topic. They can learn much more than that can be taught in the classroom by themselves. They get science concepts alive in front of them in the safer environment. They can do virtual dissection also without disturbing the ecosystem. And we have even AR Magic Cube also. That is again in the beta launch, not fully in commercial market. Students can see the holographic projection of all the content inside that. That is mixed reality we are putting into it. So for
Amazing.
enriching the creativity, we are having application color. So whatever child will color, it will come alive in the same color. They can play with them, and they can come to know the interesting facts. The character tells the story to the kids. They love like how there's a color application is there. It comes with book that is available on the commercial front also.
Amazing. And how are you providing this product to the students? I have seen your ads on Amazon and I have seen your product on Amazon. So that is one good way. But are you also connecting with the schools to provide this content to directly to the students?
Yeah, it's very difficult to means chase schools to implement all these solutions to their students. So we started to launch first these in Amazon, FirstCry, Play Store, and Flipkart also, and in our website also, they can just shop it out. And we are providing in offline stores also. We are not directing hitting the schools to implement these solutions, but yeah, after having a commercial front, we onboarded our two preschools, major preschools, Hello Kids, who is having a 600 branches all over in India, and the Kola Preschool. So these two schools are using our product, Avidia AR Magic Media, and the coloring book color, which comes under three series: land animals, fishes, underwater, and the dinosaurs.
Amazing. So let's talk about augmented reality in learning, which you are already doing, which we are already talking. So how do you see this is going to change the education system, and how do you see it's going to decide the new future of learning? So what is your perspective on this?
So, in my view, AR and VR is such kind of technology that helps students focus on the area of interest and spark encouragement to chase their dreams, I must say. If we put three generations together in the room and ask them about their education experience, it won't be shocking revelation that all three have been educated via the same old methods. For
Absolutely.
decades, the focus on India is on the instruction-based learning, rote learning, and the marks-based system. They don't know that how to encourage the child to make a future skills ready. So, however, we are miles away from creating a classroom that our students deserve. You can remember the dissecting a rat in the classroom and frog in the classroom, but it's totally banned in India right now. But our students can still do that thing into a virtual reality and augmented reality without harming the ecosystem, without harming any living beings. So this is a revolutionary way AR and VR technology is helping out. So having trouble, if you are having a trouble in understanding any topics in curriculum, so all of us face difficulty in grasping certain topics, subjects. When reading and watching videos is not sufficient, AR and VR definitely is a rescue system for that thing. So AR helps to visualize the subject because it's not a picture. It's indeed a 1,000 words AR and VR lets students inside that thing. Teachers and students can interact in a 3D dimensional environment. All this leads to a prolonged memory also. It's a long-term memorization because I am a neural network student. I know that something is going in a long-term memorization and something is in short-term memorization. So we want that everything, whatever child is studying, that the basic knowledge should be go into a long-term memorization. And AR and VR done a wonderful job in that thing. So it's very exciting to see the formation of sun flying in the space and flying in the molecules in between and sitting inside the human body and see the pumping of human heart and see the nuclear fission and fusion happening in the book. So that's why we are aligning all these things into a books and the video format when we can interact with that thing. So AR and VR, I must say that it's a wonderful technology to leverage around and we must say that it's sparked the child's brain curiosity and imagination power.
Education industry has not seen many changes for past 100 years, and education has been same. Due to COVID, we saw the digitization of the classrooms. We saw people are more and more engaging using online platforms, learning their subjects. Now there is augmented reality and virtual reality. What is the add-on of this technology, and how you feel that this technology is going to even enhance the experience of learning? And is it going to be helpful?
Yes, and that experience is very real time. Students can't feel that they are not inside that thing. They feel that they are inside that thing. So that's the difference what AR and VR is happening. Because if you remember that in a childhood time, if you go in some trip, you will never forget that experience of the trip. But if I ask any chapter from 6th standard, 7th standard, you might forget some basic concepts also. So if the learning is kind where children are going somewhere and learning something, then it would be a major impact it's creating in the child's memory.
Absolutely, absolutely. Because we remember experiences in different ways than actually reading something or understanding, or somebody else is saying and we are just listening. So this is going to be this is going to stored in mind like an experience itself. So it's going to be remembered forever. Amazing. So let's also talk about the future of the classrooms, because I have seen people who are seriously working in this journey where they're trying to augment the whole classroom or create the classroom inside virtual reality. And there is a whole organization which is working, which is educators in virtual reality, educators in VR. We are also partner with them, so we are also collaborating with them in several ways. But the overall objective is transcending a person in classroom, which is virtual, and we can basically give them all sort of education. So what is your perspective on that?
Okay, so if I'm talking about the classroom, it will take many iterations before fully customized into his schools and in classrooms, and to adapt the teacher, and Amber is the same.
Surely.
Every year we are causing damage to the planet, but using the technology will enable our children to have an eco-friendly classroom. They will be learning subjects in real time at a click of button, what you have mentioned also. And it's a magical world for a student. That's why we are not targeting the schools, the classrooms to fully adapt this technology, or you are having an AR. And because we started, honestly speaking, we started this thing with the AR and VR lab to the schools, to the students, but we failed in that part because it won't work, because it will take time. And due to COVID, and this 2020 year shows everything can become online. Now schools are changing their perspective. But before 2020, no one is believing that children's education can be online, can be interactive, can be immersive like that. But now maybe, the situation will change, and school will also adapt the online thing. But AR and VR thing, that will take time to come in school and students' part. But in commercial, that's why we are not giving that solution to the schools ready. We are giving all the solution in a commercial front, so that student parents can buy that thing directly from any commercial online or online stores. And if school are interested, then they are most welcome to become a part of our journey.
Amazing. As I previous previously mentioned, there from a prototype to a product, it's a huge and a long journey. So
yeah.
Would like love to know about some challenges of your work, and how did you overcome that? What is your philosophy of getting over the hurdles?
So we started with many prototype of augmented reality thing. We have seen the worst of that augmented reality work, and the best also. Best you are seeing in our product side, whatever are there in launched state, and the worst also. Because whatever challenges we are facing initial time, maybe you are become rid of that after some time, after years and years, you will become pro, and everything is coming inside your DNA. You are become, say, a player of that thing. Sachin is also not a Sachin by day one game or 1 year, 2 year. It
Absolutely.
Will take a long, it's a journey. Yeah, it's a sprint. It's not a sprint, it's a marathon. I said that startup is a marathon, not a sprint. So we started with such kind of prototypes. We started with AR and VR laboratory things, and we are giving 3D classrooms to the schools. But that won't work it out. Then we decided to move it out in the completely B2C section part. We are focusing more on customer side. That's why we make a product. We have taken a product from MVP side. We have tested with some group, some parents. And after that, we launched that product into a market thing. After getting a valuable feedbacks, we have done some changes, some input, some feedback. So this is called a smart system to work it out, to make changes according to real-time feedback, and then launched into a market.
Amazing. So it's a constant process of updating the product based on what are the requirements, what are the feedbacks of the market, what are the feedbacks of users. Constant updates are there, right?
Yeah. It's because MVP is the one thing which you are just for a few number of people, where you are just constantly looking out that how the product will work in market. It's a validation process that it's well, it can be work good in the market or not, whether it's good to go or not to go to.
Absolutely. So as a CEO of Avidya Labs, how do you see Avidya Lab progressing into the future?
So as I mentioned that startup is a sprint, it's not a sprint, it's a marathon.
It's a marathon.
So our long-term plan is to completely change our children's learn and how to they are perceiving information right now. So our way, as I mentioned, is a digital, in which we have a physical tangible stuff, whether it's toys or cards or books, and then we are overlaying some digital application over it, and we are creating the experience in the learning environment. So we have a plan to develop a pressure sensitive augmented reality toys also for the kindergarten thing. Yeah, and we want that product in a patent form, and for primary and secondary students, we have a one-stop application where children are getting 3D, AR and VR, everything in a one application. They just need to download the application. 3D we are keeping free for every children, and for AR and VR thing, we are giving a one cube is there for augmented reality experience thing. And for VR thing, they can just use any platform, whether it's Cardboard, whether it's Oculus, Oculus Go, HTC Vive, anything they can use. because our content is supporting multi hardware part and multi language too. So we have a plan for that where children are getting all the science, mathematics concepts, all the curriculum they can get in an interactive and immersive manner. Yeah.
Fantastic. I have one more question to you. This question is kind of a tricky because this question is from all the developers who are in the community. So their biggest challenge right now with augmented reality is that, okay, they are a developer, they have the highest end of devices, that is fine. But if they want to release a product into the masses, not all the devices has the augmented reality capabilities, not all the devices support AR core or things like that. So what is the best way of tackling such situation? Should they focus on just to the future markets, or should they also focus on the current and reduce their products to the minimum?
So I will talk as a company now because we have a team of developers, designers and artists and content SMEs. We have a team of that. But as a startup or as a company, if I'm talking about that, how they have to release the augmented reality thing. So they need to categorize something into their mind that what market they are targeting. If they are targeting the masses, they have to release that thing because you know that our NVIDIA AR Magicpedia and Color that are supporting any Android phone which is having a gyroscopic sensor. So that's the only way. They just need to turn on the camera and they can see the augmented reality stuff. But you know that augmented reality core is again a technology that is again very good technology. And we have launched one application for that. So we have segmented our target section. So we are going to launch if in a commercial market, we need some augmented reality application that is hitting in the masses and that can run in any smartphones which is having a gyroscopic sensor. And you know, any 10,000 to 12,000 ranging phone is having a gyroscopic sensor nowadays because of these so many Chinese hardware mobile. As of now, apps are banned, but Chinese phones remains, they are in market. But if they are banned too, then India is also having so much capability to bring so many smartphones of such kind of range which is supporting augmented reality thing. And augmented reality core technology, we have used that technology in one of the application, Rattus AR, that is again recognized by PETA also, where you just need to scan the room and you can convert any room into biology lab or chemistry lab or physics lab. In that Rattus AR, they can just scan the room and they can convert it into biology lab. And they can see rat in front of that. They can learn about the life cycle of the rat, anatomy of the rat, and they can do the dissection part in front of them on any platform.
Absolutely, absolutely amazing. So this is the end of our podcast. And Vidya, if you have any message for all the developers or all the parents who should purchase this amazing technologies for their children, because as you mentioned, the experience which we'll get is going to be amazing, which will be something they'll remember forever. So what is your message to people?
So my message to the parents that yes, parents are very worried about that there is a screen time for their kids. But I must say, if you are giving that thing because you are giving the cell phones while eating while feeding them. But you are afraid of giving while learning time. So that's the major blockage of today's parents. They need to understand the time gap. Their time is different. Their kids' time is different. So they need to give a learning kind of thing with the technology part because children's learn more motivated to play more rather than learning, because learning is not so interesting. If we give the learning in a gamified manner, then the parents is also happy to feed them with the screen time while learning, while playing also. And for the developers community, I have one message that technology is very powerful, and if leveraged in the right way and made universally accessible, it will connect the world while harnessing the opportunity of the digital age to benefit every child. So try hard to serve innovative solution to the country and make India Atmanirbhar.
Fantastic, fantastic message for everyone. So with that, let's end our podcast here. And thanks for coming on the show. We are really glad to have you. You gave us some really amazing points that the learning should not always be boring. It could be fun, it could be interactive, it could be futuristic. It could teach us a lot more about the technology. And amazing, we are love to have you here. And thanks for coming on our show.
Thank you so much, Avi. Thank you for this wonderful opportunity. It's nice to connect to you, nice to talk to you. Thank you, guys.
So this was Vidya Chaudhary, who's founder of Avidya Labs, and she had such an amazing conversation about augmented learning, where people, where students are learning about the technology, science, arts, in interactive way with using augmented reality. So for this, we'll release the next episode of XR News tomorrow. And have a great day, guys. Have a happy Sunday, and keep helping each other in this COVID-19 time. Stay at home as much as possible, and have a great day.